me hearties, and welcome back to the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinking Spot Her. You know, I've been thinking about poetry a lot, because it's the Poetry Corner and Thinking Spot. And I came across this great poem by Rudyard Kipling. It's entitled The Norman and Saxon, AD 1100. And I'm thinking this sort of captures a little bit of the spirit. I'll read it to you. Norman and Saxon, 1100 AD, by Rudyard Kipling. My son, said the Norman Baron, I'm dying, and you will be heir to all the broad acres in England that William gave me to share when he conquered the Saxons at Hastings. And a nice little handful it is. Now, when he's talking about William, he means William the Conqueror. Right? Wait, so, you know, he's talking about 1066, so it's a few years later. And so, of course, this Norman Baron fought with William, and so William gave him a bit of land for helping him. But anyway, I deviate from the poem. So I'll continue. When he conquered the Saxons at Hastings, and a nice little handful it is. But before you go over to rule it, I want you to understand this. The Saxon is not like us Normans. His manners are not so polite. But he never means anything serious till he talks about justice and right. When he stands like an ox in the furrow with his sullen eyes set on your own and grumbles, that isn't fair dealing. My son, leave the Saxon alone. You can horsewhip your Gascony archers or torture your Picardy spears, but don't try that game on the Saxon. You'll have the whole brood down round on about your ears. From the richest old thane in the country to the poorest chained serf in the field, they'll be at you, they'll be on you like hornets. And if you are wise, you will yield. But first, you must master their language, their dialect, proverbs, and songs. Don't trust any old clerk to interpret when they come to tell you the tale of their wrongs. Let them know that you know what they're saying. Let them feel that you know what to say. Yes, even when you want to go hunting, hear them out if it takes them all day. They'll drink every hour of the daylight and poach every hour of the dark. It sounds like a pirate, right? Well, here, we like our rum. Yes, we do. And, you know, we'll go out to pillaging and plundering. And I'm sorry, I'm deviating from the poem. We'll go back to the Norman. The Norman is explaining the Saxons to his son. They'll drink every hour of the daylight and poach every hour of the dark. It's the sport, not the rabbits they're after, and we've plenty of game in the park. Don't hang them or cut off their fingers. That's wasteful as well as unkind, for a hard-bitten South Country poacher makes the best men-at-arms you can find. Sort of like a pirate, you know. You know, we've got it rough, so we make the best soldiers you can find, the best combatants. We know our way around the steel and the flint and the powder, if you take my meaning here. Anyway, I'm deviating again from the poem. I must apologize. I get so excited, you know. So, anyway, back to the poem. The South Country poacher makes the best men-at-arms you can find. Appear with your wife and your children at their weddings and funerals and feasts. Be polite, but not friendly, to bishops. Be good to all poor parish priests. Say we, us, and ours when you're talking, instead of you fellas and I. Don't ride over seeds. Keep your temper. And never you tell them a lie. There. That's how it is, you know. That's how it is for the pirates, too. We don't want no double-dealing, no cross-dealing. We want a straight deal. You know, and that's why the pirate ships, you know, pirate ships were egalitarian democracies. You know, the captain was only in charge during times of battle. Everything else, the quartermaster ruled the roost with the permission of all the crew. Everyone had a vote. Anyway, that be all for today's Pirate's Poetry Corner. A little Rudyard Kipling for you. So, till next time, fair winds to your sails. Keep your weather eye open and your powder dry.